Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India. Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 1st of May. India's COVID-19 tally crosses 35,000 mark. Sri Lankan president rejects opposition call to reconvene parliament. And Nepal PM Oli calls for unity to fight against coronavirus. And now for all the details. India's COVID-19 tally crossed the 35,000 mark on Friday with over 1,140 deaths reported so far. This comes as the second phase of nationwide lockdown is scheduled to end on May 3rd. The total number of COVID-19 cases climbed to 35,043 in India on Friday, while the death toll rose to 1,147, with 72 more fatalities in the last 24 hours. Indian Health Ministry Joint Secretary Lav Agarwal said the recovery rate of infected patients in India has steadily climbed to 25.37%, up from 13% about 14 days ago. Indian government has designated some major cities, including capital New Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Bengaluru and Ahmedabad as red zones, indicating that nationwide lockdown in these places is unlikely to be eased after May 3rd.
Rajya aur Jila Prashasan dwara concentrated efforts karte hue yeh ensure karna hai ki jin bhi jilon mein case aaye hain, yani ki red ya orange districts, wahan par effective aur stringent contained measures ke through chain of transmission ko break kiya jaye.
On Thursday, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi held comprehensive meeting with senior ministers to discuss strategies to attract more investments and promote local investments in order to give a boost to the economy against the backdrop of the COVID-19 pandemic. Pakistan's National Assembly Speaker Asad Qaisar is the latest politician to test positive for the coronavirus that has infected over 16,800 people across the country. Pakistan is under lockdown for a fifth consecutive week to contain coronavirus spread.
Pakistan's National Assembly Speaker Asad Qaisar on Thursday became the highest government functionary to test positive for the novel coronavirus that has infected 16,817 people across the country. Qaisar tweeted, "I tested positive for coronavirus and quarantined myself in my house." He urged the nation to take precautions and sought their prayers. Qaisar's son and daughter have also tested positive for the novel coronavirus. His announcement comes just days after Sindh Governor Imran Ismail also tested for COVID-19. Meanwhile, the offices of the National Assembly Secretariat will remain closed until May 9. The nationwide tally of COVID-19 patients stands at 16,817, with 6,340, the highest cases reported in Punjab province. The virus has claimed at least 385 lives, while at least 4,315 coronavirus patients have recovered. Pakistan is on lockdown for the fifth consecutive week, and the federal government is preparing to loosen lockdown restrictions.
Moving on, Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has rejected a call by seven opposition parties to reconvene the parliament amid COVID-19 outbreak. The president had dissolved the parliament in March, 6 months ahead of the schedule.
Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has declined a request from the opposition parties to reconvene the dissolved parliament, according to a statement by the president's office on Thursday. On April 27, seven opposition parties had urged President Gotabaya Rajapaksa to summon the dissolved parliament while pledging cooperation to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic. Gotabaya had dissolved the parliament on March 2, 6 months ahead of the schedule, and called a snap election on April 25 to elect a new 225-member house. However, the Election Commission in mid-April postponed the parliamentary elections to June 20th due to the coronavirus outbreak, which has so far infected 665 people and claimed 7 lives in the island nation. In the latest, Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa has called a meeting of members of the previous parliament on May 4th as the country stares at a financial crisis due to the virus.
In news from Afghanistan, a watchdog report to the US Congress has warned that Afghanistan, beset by a poor healthcare system, war and other vulnerabilities, is likely facing a health disaster from the coronavirus.
Afghanistan, beset by a poor healthcare system, malnutrition, war and other vulnerabilities, likely is facing a health disaster from the coronavirus, a watchdog report to the US Congress warns. The report, released late on Thursday by Special Inspector General for Afghanistan Reconstruction, or SIGAR, John Sopko, said the spread of COVID-19 already has significantly impacted Afghanistan, from complicating the peace initiative to forcing border crossing closures that have disrupted commercial and humanitarian deliveries. The report said Afghanistan's numerous and in some cases unique vulnerabilities, a weak healthcare system, widespread malnutrition, porous borders, massive internal displacement, contiguity with Iran and ongoing conflict make it likely the country will confront a health disaster in the coming months. Rising food prices in the impoverished country likely will worsen the crisis, Sopko said in a letter accompanying the report. Afghanistan has confirmed nearly 2,200 coronavirus cases and 64 deaths so far, according to local news reports, quoting the health ministry.
Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli has called on for unity amongst party factions to fight against COVID-19 pandemic as coronavirus cases surge in the country. The total number of COVID-19 patients in the country is 57. Amid rising rift in ruling Nepal Communist Party, Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli on Friday called on for unity amongst party factions to fight against COVID-19 pandemic as the Himalayan nation lately has seen surge in infection cases. In a recorded statement released Friday on the occasion of May Day, Oli called for resilience to fight against problems created by the pandemic that has so far infected 57 people in the country.
यस मे दिवसको सङ्गारमा आज हामी कोरोना महामारीका विरुद्धको युद्धमा होमिएका छौँ तत्कालको लागि हाम्रो प्रयास यस महामारीले सिर्जना गरेको समस्या सामना गर्नेतर्फ केन्द्रित छ यतिखेर सरकार कोरोना सङ्क्रमणको रोकथाम पहिचान परीक्षण र उपचारमा लागि परेको छ
The rift within the Nepal Communist Party escalated after two ordinances facilitating split of parties was scrapped within days of its endorsement. Party chair Pushpa Kamal Dahal and leader Madhav Kumar Nepal had asked Oli to step down from the post. Their factions have accused PM Oli of making decisions unilaterally without consultation with the party. Meanwhile, secretariat meeting held Wednesday remained inconclusive and another meeting in continuation to that has been called on for Saturday. Oli also floated the name of party leader Bamdev Gautam as his successor, sending ripples across the political spectrum. Moving on to Bangladesh, the COVID-19 pandemic is threatening to upend the economic order of several countries, causing upheaval in several businesses. The iconic horse carriages of Bangladesh's capital, Dhaka, are sitting idle as their business has all but dried up due to the coronavirus lockdown.
The iconic horse carriages of Bangladesh's capital, Dhaka, are sitting idle and their owners say they are struggling to feed the equines as the business has all but dried up due to the coronavirus lockdown. The city has been in lockdown for more than a month and the carriages, which in normal days are used by commuters travelling short distances as well as for events like weddings or commercial shoots, are now mostly parked by the roadside.
The coronavirus is coming, we are all closed. We have a lot নাটকের কাজও ভাড়া দেয় বিভিন্ন সরকারি অ্যাডেও দেয় তো এই করোনা দুর্ভোগে আমরা খুবই দুর্ভোগ আছি
Many of the carriages are family business, with young children also helping to take care of the horses. Mohammed Rifat and some of the other stable boys were seen cutting grass from fields to feed their charges. There are about an estimated 80 such carriages on Dhaka streets. Until 1950, they were the main mode of transport for people in the city, but modern vehicles have increasingly made them obsolete and they are now used also for their novelty factor. Bangladesh has reported 7,667 cases of the coronavirus and 168 deaths as on Friday.
Devotees in eastern India's Kolkata city performed a holy fire ritual this week to invoke divine blessings and relief from the coronavirus that has killed over 233,000 people worldwide.
Devotees in India's eastern Kolkata city invoked the gods and performed special prayers this week to pray for relief from coronavirus that has killed over 233,000 people worldwide. A priest chanted prayers and burnt balls inserted with pins representing the deadly coronavirus in fire as devotees wearing masks participated in the yajna or holy fire ritual. The organizer of the holy ritual said they hoped for help from God against the pandemic which has affected people's lives and livelihood across the world.
तो भगवान को बुला रहे जैसे कोरोना सारा विश्व में जैसे कोरोना के लिए बहुत आदमी मर गया बहुत आदमी खाना भी नहीं मिलता है कल कारखाना हर बार बंद हो जा रहा है उसलिए आज एक क्या किया हम लोग सारा विश्व शांति आने के लिए अब जोग कर रहे हैं.
With more than 35,000 cases and a humble health infrastructure, India is buckling down to battle coronavirus.
A car shaped like coronavirus is now out on the streets of India's eastern Bhubaneswar city. An artist has turned his motorcycle into a car shaped like coronavirus to spread awareness about COVID-19 outbreak and precautionary measures.
Indian artist Pramod Mudali has turned his motorcycle into a car shaped like coronavirus to spread awareness about precautionary measures. Mudali covered it with foam after armature welding on his motorcycle. He painted slogans and artwork about social distancing, wearing of mask and lockdown on the corona car.
और उसका उसका ऊपर एक गवर्नमेंट का मैसेज भी लिखा हुआ था वो मैसेज का देख के लोग भी सचेतन हो जाएगा तो इसीलिए मैं मेरा बाइक को कार बना दिया.
India is under lockdown till May 3rd to curb the spread of coronavirus pandemic. However, lockdown has not been rosy for many, including daily wage workers and farmers. Farmers in several North Indian cities are destroying tons of flowers as they are unable to sell it amid the ongoing lockdown. A farmer in Meerut city said that since there are no festivals being celebrated and no extravagant weddings, therefore there is no demand for flowers.
Kya kahin bahar ke utwane ke liye bhi bahut badi lagat chahiye bahut badi labor chahiye jisse aaj tak lagi hui thi ab ummeed agadi ki bhi nahi dikhai de rahi saaf hone ki is wajah se jisse jot ke nayi fasal ki taiyari karenge.
India is under the largest lockdown in the world involving over 1 billion people since late March. Only essential services like food, medicines, information, etc. are allowed to function during this lockdown.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. India's COVID-19 tally crosses 35,000 mark. Sri Lankan president rejects opposition call to reconvene parliament. And Nepal PM Oli calls for unity to fight against coronavirus. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.